Do you know your blood type? Many people don't. Even if you do, you might not realize that your blood type can make you more susceptible to certain diseases. Some conditions tend to affect people with specific blood types more than others. One blood type, in particular, is considered especially risky. Are you in this group? I hope not. In this video, I'll explain the different blood types and the diseases linked to each one. We'll also touch on the topic of blood type-based diets. Is there any scientific proof behind it? You'll discover everything you need to know about the most dangerous blood type in the world, so stick around for vital health information. It would be much easier for hospitals and blood banks if everyone had the same blood type, but that's not the case. So, how do we determine blood types? Blood types are defined by the presence or absence of specific antigens. An antigen is a chemical substance that can trigger an immune response when the body recognizes it as foreign. These antigens act like markers for our immune system, allowing recognized cells to pass as friends and eliminating those seen as enemies. Blood types are primarily classified using two systems, ABO and Rh, rhesus. The ABO system is based on the presence of A and B antigens on the surface of red blood cells. A person is type A if they have the A antigen, type B if they have the B antigen, type AB if they have both, or type O if they have neither antigen. The Rh classification is determined by the presence or absence of a protein called the Rh factor. If this protein is present, the blood type is Rh positive, if it's absent, it's Rh negative. These two systems combine to define the eight most common blood types: A positive or negative, B positive or negative, O positive or negative, and AB positive or negative. Do you know which is the most common blood type in the world? It's O positive, followed closely by A positive. The rarest blood type is AB negative. Why is it so important to know your blood type? In a blood transfusion, it can literally be the difference between life and death, whether you're receiving blood or donating it to someone in need. A transfusion might be required after a serious accident, in cases of significant blood loss, or during major surgery. A surgeon may ask you to store a reserve of blood in case it's needed during an operation. Premature babies, cancer or leukemia patients, women who've lost a lot of blood during childbirth, people with intestinal or gastric bleeding, as well as those with anemia or sickle cell disease, may all require blood transfusions. There are many reasons why a transfusion can be essential. Blood banks sometimes run low on supplies, especially for rare blood types like AB and certain Rh negatives. Although O negative is relatively common, it's considered the universal red blood cell donor. This blood type lacks A and B antigens and the Rh factor, making it compatible with any recipient without the risk of rejection. That's why it's frequently used in emergencies, and it's often in short supply at blood centers. However, O negative donors can only receive blood from their own type. People with AB positive blood are universal plasma donors because they don't have antibodies against A or B antigens, and they can receive blood from any group, making them universal recipients. As the immune system develops, it produces antibodies against any foreign antigen. For example, a person with type B blood receiving type A blood risks a potentially fatal incompatibility reaction, as the anti-A antibodies in their plasma would attack the donor's red blood cells, causing them to clump together and block blood flow. But how is your blood type determined? It's inherited from your parents. Each person receives one copy of each gene from their mother and father, which defines their blood type. For instance, if both my spouse and I are B positive, we could only have children with either B or O blood types, as the O allele is recessive. That's exactly what happened. My daughter is O negative, and my son is B negative. If we'd had a child with type A blood, it would mean the baby had been swapped at the hospital. In addition to the antigens we've already discussed, there are over 600 recognized antigens, the presence or absence of which defines extremely rare blood types. Fortunately, most of us have antigens that don't complicate our ability to give or receive blood. However, some people have such a rare blood type that only one or two individuals out of millions would be compatible donors if they ever needed a transfusion. Imagine having a blood type so unique that fewer than 50 people in the world, with a handful of them in Brazil, share it. This could become a monumental challenge if you needed a transfusion after an accident, surgery, or complications during childbirth. What is the rarest and potentially most problematic blood type? It's called Rh-null, also known as golden blood. Despite its fascinating name, this blood type offers no special benefits. In fact, not only is it extremely rare, but the red blood cells of individuals with Rh-null are more fragile than usual. If you belong to this rare group, the only blood you can receive in a transfusion must come from another Rh-null individual. Golden blood stands out because of the complete absence of Rh system antigens on red blood cells, which makes this group so rare. Furthermore, many people with this blood type are unaware they belong to such an exclusive category. Do you know your blood type? If not, how can you find out? A complete blood count won't reveal this information, as it only analyzes red and white blood cells and platelets. If you check your old blood test results, look for an indication of your blood type and Rh factor. If you can't find it, you can request a specific blood typing test or donate blood. By donating, not only will you learn your blood type, but you could also save up to 4 lives. Now, let's talk about the blood type diet. Is there any scientific evidence behind it? Advocates of this method claim that certain foods are healthier based on your blood type. One of my patients swore that this diet had significantly improved his life. But where does this theory come from? It originated from the best-selling book Eat Right for Your Type, published in the 1990s. According to this book, people with type O blood, supposedly descended from hunters, should consume more protein-rich foods like meat, chicken, and fish, while limiting legumes, very much like the paleo diet. Type A, the farmer's blood type, should avoid red meat and adopt a more vegetarian lifestyle. Type B, labeled as the nomad, can eat both plant-based foods and meat, except for chicken and pork, and they can consume dairy. However, they should avoid wheat, corn, lentils, and tomatoes. Finally, type AB, often called the enigma, combines traits of both A and B types. All these diets emphasize eliminating processed foods, which might explain why some people see improvements in their health. However, the idea that lectins and food interact differently depending on your blood type, as proposed by this theory, has been debunked by studies, including an in-depth review published in 2013. Experts concluded that there is no scientific evidence supporting the benefits of blood type diets. But is there a link between your blood type and your personality? In Japan, it was once believed that, much like astrological signs, blood types influenced personality. For example, type A individuals were thought to be kind and perfectionistic, while type B people were considered optimistic and independent. However, a study showed that there is no correlation between blood type and personality. When it comes to diseases, though, is there a connection with blood type? According to a Harvard study, people with type O blood have a lower risk of heart disease, while those with type AB have the highest risk. That said, it's crucial to monitor your blood pressure, glucose, and cholesterol levels and maintain a healthy lifestyle. One other benefit of type O blood is a reduced risk of stroke, which is similar to a heart attack. However, this blood type isn't without its risks, as people with type O are more prone to ulcers and skin cancer. On the other hand, people with type A have a higher likelihood of developing stomach cancer, often linked to Helicobacter pylori bacteria. Additionally, they tend to have higher levels of cortisol, a hormone associated with stress. In the end, while you can't change your blood type, you can certainly improve your lifestyle, exercise more, avoid harmful habits like smoking, manage stress, get better sleep, and live life to the fullest. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to click the like button, subscribe to the channel so you don't miss any of our health tips, and activate the bell to receive notifications. Feel free to share this information with your loved ones, as it could be vital to their health. Thank you, and stay healthy until the next video.